Hello everyone, three. Again, I am present here for my next video. Today, I am going to show you about the brief description, function, and uses of level machine. How level machine works. Okay, now let us know first what is level machine. Okay, here is a description. A level machine is an optical instrument used to establish or verify points in the same horizontal plane in a process known as leveling, and is used in conjunction with a leveling staff to establish the relative heights, level of objects or marks. In simple terms, level machine is an instrument to know elevation or level of some particular points, like buildings, roads, or some particular points with respect to known points. We'll transfer level from benchmark or some known points using staff. There are different types of auto level. The history of auto level, level machine. Now let us know the types of level machine used. This is Dumpy level. In this level, there are two bubble on the top of this tube. In the description below, I am giving the brief description about types of level detailedly. You can see it there. Now here it is. This longitudinal bubble, cross bubble, diaphragm, eyepiece, focusing screw, tri-base, circular compass. These are the components of Dumpy level. Now next one is Wye level or Wye level. This is not generally used, as setting station is quite complicated here. Okay, now third is tilting level. This is the most used level machine before auto level was introduced. There are different types of tilting level. Okay, now the fourth one is Cook's reversible level. This is a combination of Wye level and Dumpy level, but the auto level replaced this instrument. Now this is auto level. Today we are going to see brief detail about auto level. How does it works, and what are the components inside auto level? Okay, now let us go through what is auto level. The auto level is an automatically leveling high performance optical instrument useful during site surveys and building construction to gather, transfer or set horizontal levels and grade application. Okay, this is same as level machine, but why it is called auto level is because of the compensator present inside this auto level. Inside auto level, there is a compensator which compensates 15 minutes of error, tilting error, and balances it. This is the precise types of compensator. Okay, now I'll show you later regarding compensator. There is auto level details. This is target collimator, focusing knob for focusing. This is eyepiece for my making crosshair. Now this is spirit level, screwing level, horizontal circle, showing angle reading from 0 degree to 360 degree, or in some auto level gauge reading can also be seen. This is horizontal drive for shifting target left to right. This output lens target is shifted using horizontal drive screw. Now inside auto level there is compensator. I'm showing you brief description about compensator. Okay, now this is working procedure of auto level. Now while we see target from our eyes, okay, while we see target from our eyes, the light is passed through eyepiece. This is eyepiece, passed through eyepiece and reaches the compensator. Now this is compensator. Inside auto level there is compensator, and it consists of three prisms, two at side and one at the center. The side prism reflects light, and the symbol and this center prism is hung using wires at two sides, which is hung under the action of gravity. This balances the compensator to remain horizontal. Now when the light is passed, the first prism reflects light and sends it to center prism, and which again reflects it back to third prism and finally passed out. And staff reading can be done or some required target. As this compensates 0 to 15 minutes. Now let me show you how compensator works if the auto level is tilted. Okay, here it is. Let me show you how compensator works. First, this is a Wye level condition and light passing is no problem. This is horizontal and reflection is simple here. For the second condition, now Wye the machine is not properly level, instrument is not properly level, the light is passed. Okay, now here is the target and here is the eyepiece. Now from the target the light passed to the prism, and this prism reflects is to center prism. The center prism is hung under the action of gravity. So the center prism is hung under the action of gravity, and it remains vertical. It remains vertical whether the machine is tilted or leveled properly. Now this center prism passes light to the other side prism, and it passes light in such a way that the light passes from third prism remains in a horizontal by the action of this three prism. Although the machine is instrument is tilted, the light pass remains horizontal, which provides same accuracy as level machine. The condition is it can compensate error up to 15 minutes only. Otherwise we need to adjust error. I have shown you in the video how auto level error is checked. Please refer to my next video. Okay, now auto level not only provides elevation details, preliminary survey and distance calculation can also be done using auto level. You can see it, preliminary survey can be done using auto level. It gives all the details required for plan, profile and cross section. Rough survey can be done, and another rough distance can be calculated, which can save time while surveying. Even rough distance can also be calculated. Let me show you how distance is calculated. In the auto level, while you see from eyepiece, we can see the cross here where under one vertical line three cross line are provided. First one is top stadia mark, central stadia mark and bottom stadia mark. For distance calculation, top stadia mark and bottom stadia mark is to be noted, and the difference of top and bottom stadia marks into 100 times gives the rough distance, that is the distance from staff to the auto level eyepiece. Okay, for example, let me show you here. Upper stereo mark is 4.90 and lower stereo mark is 4.672. Now difference between upper and lower stereo mark is 4.90 minus 4.672, that is 0.228. now multiply 0.228 by 100 times and we will get 22.8 meter. It means that the auto level is 22.8 meter away from leveling staff. This is rough distance, only for rough purpose. Okay, this is same process as I have shown you earlier. Upper stereo reading is noted and lower stereo reading is noted, and difference between two stereo reading is calculated, and it's multiplied by 100 times to know the rough distance in meter. This is the distance between staff and auto level eyepiece. Okay, now second one is how survey can be done using auto level. As I have said you, this is not the accurate type of survey, but preliminary survey, for preliminary survey it's okay. It's not necessary to take total station or thorough light for preliminary survey, as it is costly, time consuming and require skill manpower. By using this auto level, the work can be done very fastly. Let me show you the process using auto level. Now first, the instrument is set up properly and leveled properly. Its station point is marked properly now, and then the instrument is sighted towards north. You need not need to target instrument to the north accurately, roughly target can also be okay, and set the horizontal circle reading to 0 degree on the auto level. On the below parts of auto level there is horizontal circle reading marks from 0 degree to 360 degree. Now set that, rotate that horizontal circle and set to 0 degree towards north side, and then set the staff towards benchmark where the elevation is provided or RL point is given, and take the reading like horizontal circle reading and staff reading. Like if the horizontal circle reading is set 0 at north and towards benchmark, if it's 30 degree then mark horizontal circle reading at 30 degree and take staff reading. Now we can do it same for other multiple points, like road center, or if survey is for canal then center line of canal etc. And for changing station, now for changing station the thing to be considered is the next point where station is set is to be noted properly, and station point mark is to be given and reading is to be taken properly. You can see for changing station, mark the foresight properly and set up the instrument. Now the instrument is shifted from first station to the second station, and then staff is kept on the first station. Now and then level the machine properly and target to the previous station where staff is kept, and mark horizontal circle reading 0 degree to that station. By doing this, this links the relation between two station. Okay, mark the foresight properly and set up the instrument to that point. Okay, and turn the instrument towards previous station and set horizontal to 0 degree FCD. Now keep staff to the point you want to survey. Okay, now again from this station other multiple points can be surveyed, and note that every horizontal angle reading and staff reading is to be noted. Every point can be surveyed by this process. Okay, this process is repeated for every required station. Every time you need to target to the previous station and set horizontal circle as 0 degree, and then you can do other readings, other point also. Okay, the obtained, this process is repeated for every required station, and the obtained points can further be converted to required format using Gale's traverse table if required. Like if the the point is first stored on the computer or noted on computer, and then by using Gale's traverse table it can be converted to north easting elevation as per requirement. Okay, for today this is it. Thank you for watching. On my next video I'm going to show you the detail about compensator, how compensator works and the types of compensator, how it is hung, and what are the prisms, how are the prisms set there. Okay, please subscribe this channel for more updates. See you on next video. Thank you.